So we're in Houston, Texas. What we call this job is Towers North. The unique thing about this building is that it has a lockstrip glazing system. Most of these buildings that have that type of system are now showing their age. They're neoprene rubber, which when exposed to UV over time starts to degrade. So many of these are starting to show problems, leakage. Generally with this type of glazing system, you've got three broad choices. Wet sealing, where you're taking sealant and trying to butter up where cracks may be occurring, where the seal may be broken between the glass. Another option at the other extreme would be completely replacing your curtain wall.
The complete replacement is just not economical at all. It's way, way expensive. Something that has aged like this, it's a structural system, so you want to add some structural value to it, which is what this system that we're installing does.
In this particular case, we worked very closely with the consultant who worked with the owner. The consultant came up with the structural recommendation and we formed our overlay around it. We have different pieces for perimeters, kind of a C-shape that encapsulates the jam conditions. We have special corner pieces and we have something called a cruciform that you might see on this building that actually covers the intersection, just kind of cleans it up and gives it a nice look. We also have options on the type of leg that adheres to the glass. Some contractors might have a certain preference, but we always try to keep the interior sight line very clean so the occupants, once they're in the building, they look out the window, they may not even notice that it's been restored. It also cleans up the building. Most of these have gotten so old that they're kind of powdery and dusty, and as the rain washes down the building, it leaves an undesirable look. And it takes that old grain rubber gasket to a nice clean black silicone rubber, which, as we know, silicone lasts for many, many years. The fit of the overlay is a critical piece. We want it to look good. We want it to perform well. Typically, these parts are extruded, so that's a process where there's a die involved. There's a extrusion lead time. In order to speed that up and also provide an accurate fit, we utilize our in-house 3D printer. The drawing will be made with the dimensions that we take off the building through our design engineering department. We'll make a 3D print of that die drawing. We'll come out with that 3D print really within a week and can verify if that's the right snug fit that we're looking for.
You know, if the 3D print doesn't work out, then obviously they can take it back and tweak the design and then print it right back out. It's a quick turnaround, because if they start manufacturing it, we get stuff here that doesn't work, then they gotta go back and it just delays the whole process. The 3D print really expedites the whole design phase of the project.
We like to be on jobs. We're here to help them ensure fit, make sure things look good, make sure the cut lengths are coming in the size they need to be, the timing of delivery. We're also out here to meet with the consultant through the project, and if there's any recommendations we can make to verify the warrantability of the installation.
One warranty from one manufacturer is a single source warranty. It definitely helps, and it's a 20-year warranty with this system. My whole career I've known Tremco and worked with Tremco. There's not another silicone manufacturer that I know of that is doing this system.